Hi guys, this is Vaish from Vaish IAS, and we are continuing our Geography NCERT series, class 7th. This will be the last video for class 7th because there are 10 chapters. We have done up to 7 chapters, and this video does 3 chapters together, okay, 8, 9 and 10. All 3 are like I have clubbed it together because it's just dealing with the life of people and the vegetation, the animals, the plants in different locations of the earth, okay, the different climatic vegetative regions, you can tell. Like in the last chapter itself, we have seen the different types of grasslands, forest, deserts, the colder tundra taiga region. So we have seen just the names. Now we'll see a little more deeper in each chapter about what are the important animals, plants, river systems, river basins, all those things. So it will be a little bit factual. You can make a note of the things if you need, because match the following questions tends to come from these kind of things, okay, in UPSC prelims, okay, that is why. Anyway, in future classes again more things are going to come, but in smaller classes you will see the pictures also of that, so it will be kind of easy to grasp. That's why we are going class by class, okay. So let's see the chapter 8 first. Chapter 8 of class 7th. Okay, this is in the tropical and subtropical region. Okay, also the equatorial regions will be there. I think it deals with majorly the Ganga Brahmaputra basin of India and one region from the South America, the Amazon basin. Okay, so here a picture is shown of like different people from different parts of the world. So if you see, like, everybody looks different, they have their own culture, their own cuisines, their own living styles and all, but basically everybody needs food, clothing, shelter, okay, that is the basic needs, okay. And now in modern days, you can tell there are more needs, which are, you can tell the list of things which is there in the Sustainable Development Goals. So there are more things, but the basic things is food, clothing and shelter, okay, wherever the humans are living, that is what is the basic thing. So we'll see how this chapter is proceeding. So if you see here also, it's mentioned chapter 8, 9 and 10, we'll learn about the life of people in different natural regions of the world, okay, that is what we are going to do in this video. Okay, so see this blue box, first they are telling about the Amazon basin. So Amazon, how did that name come? Okay, Spanish explorers, you know, Spain was the country which invested a lot in the building of ships and then traveling across the globe, exploring new places. That is how the entire colonization age started, okay, British and all entered later only. Spanish and Portugal, if you know Vasco da Gama and all, 14th, 15th century, you know, century, they were at its peak, okay, so they were traveling places. So when they discovered the Amazon River, they were attacked by a group of local tribes wearing headgears and grass skirts, okay. These people reminded them of the fierce tribes of women warriors known in the ancient Roman Empire, okay. You know, Roman Empire was the ancient, most advanced empire, you can tell, of that time. So that there were women warriors who were called Amazons, okay, in that time. So seeing the tribes in the Amazon, actual what is the South American region, they in the near the river, they compared it with them and then decided to call them as Amazons. So that is how the name Amazon originated. And now you know Amazon is a what is it, the lungs of the earth, you can tell, because of the greenery. So that is the importance of the evolution of the name, okay. Spanish people gave that name. Now we'll see little bit details. So it is again starting from the equatorial region, where we know it's like heavy rainfall, and some 10 degree north and 10 degree south to that equator, it will be similar climate, okay. Regarding rainfall, continuous rainfall will be there, it will be very hot, lot of green canopy will be there, so those kind of things. So we'll see some features of it. Picture map obviously will help. If you see the South American map, Brazil is a very big country, and you should know one thing, the equator and the Tropic of Capricorn passes through Brazil, okay, through South America continent also, you can tell, but if you see 0 degrees here and Tropic of Capricorn 23.5 degrees somewhere here. If you see South America as a whole and Brazil as a country, these things are getting passed, okay. So another thing you have to know, Brazil is such huge that almost every country other than Brazil in South America has a border with Brazil, okay. These are extra things which I am telling you, okay. You should know, like, only I think Chile here in the westernmost side and Ecuador here does not share a boundary with Brazil. Remaining all the countries, if you see, whether it be Paraguay here, Uruguay here, Guyana, Venezuela, everything has a boundary with Brazil. That much big is Brazil as a nation, okay. So you should know Brazil is also part of our BRICS country, BRICS nations. Okay, so you should know such things which are understandable only when we see the map. Okay, and you should see Pacific Ocean is in one side and Atlantic Ocean is in another side. And here we have the Isthmus of Panama. We have learnt it in the previous chapters, which connects the South American continent with the North American continent. Also, Panama Canal will be there, which will link the Pacific Ocean with the Atlantic Ocean. So you should know the boundaries, and you should know ocean current related thing. Humboldt current passes through this. Okay, I'm telling a lot of extra information so that when we repeat it multiple times, you will be thorough with it. Okay, that's all. So that's the thing. Tributaries definition is given. You know what is a tributary, a river which will join another river. Like tributaries are not originating from the main river. Okay, it is originating somewhere else and then coming and joining to the main river. Okay, so an Amazon basin is the largest river basin in the world. That is what they are trying to tell us. So that is about Amazon basin's pictorial representation. Now we'll see climate and rainforest. Climate, how it is, it's near the equator, so obviously hot and wet climate throughout the year. Both day and night are almost equally hot and humid. Skin feels itchy, sticky, it rains almost every day, that too without warning. That means continuous rainfall. The day temperatures are very high with high humidity. Humidity means water vapor in the atmosphere. At night the temperature goes down, but the humidity remains high. Okay, so humidity is always high, rainfall is always there. So once in UPSC, I think 5-6 years back, they actually framed such a passage. Okay, like in double quotes, they gave like a poem, like this is the description of a particular place and you have to identify what place it is. So they have given all these features actually. Okay, and in options they gave like equatorial region, tropical region, desert region, like that. So you should know the features of a particular location. Okay, natural location. Now rainforest, Amazon rainforest, you know, green canopy. The forests are in fact so thick that the dense roof created by the leaves and branches does not allow the sunlight to reach the ground. That is the canopy. Okay, one bird picture you can see here, toucans in the left side. Only shade tolerant vegetation may grow here. Okay, because shade tolerance should be there, because sunlight will not be reaching till the ground. So the small plants should be shade tolerant. Orchids, bromeliads, you see this blue box, this is the definition. In our PDF also we have an MCQ for this, what is bromeliads, because UPSC will ask bromeliads in Amazon forest, what does it refer to. So you should know it is special plants that store water in the leaves. Okay, store water in the leaves, that is bromeliads. Animals like frog use these pockets of water for laying their eggs. Okay, so you should know what is bromeliads. Now let's proceed. This is an environment topic actually, but you should relate and study. Then again, bird, the picture is shown, toucans, hummingbirds, birds of paradise, colored, lot of names. Just make a note as I'm scrolling down. And then animals like monkeys, sloth, ant-eating tapirs, again, the image is here. Okay. Various species of reptiles and snakes, you know, anaconda is there in the Amazon movie, please watch that movie. Crocodiles, snakes, pythons, anaconda, boa constrictor, different names, make a note. Piranha, again, movie is there, Piranha 3D, please go and watch. Piranha fish is also found in this river. Okay, so these are our basic animals, plants and features about Amazon rainforest and climate. People, what they do, clearing forest. While men hunt and fish along the rivers, women take care of the crops. This is how their life or culture is. They mainly grow tapioca, pineapple, sweet potato. Okay. As hunting and fishing are uncertain, it is the women who keep their families alive by feeding them the vegetables they grow. Okay, because hunting and all, you know, it's like every day you can't get a good hunt, okay, or a good fish. So that is why vegetables which they grow, the crops, is much more significant. Then there is this slash and burn agriculture, which is known by different names. UPSC have asked ones, I'm asking following questions, like jhoom cultivation is one particular name of it. In Mexico or somewhere, some other name is there. So different countries or different regions has different names for it, but the overall theory is same. Okay, this blue box we'll go through. It is a way of cultivating land where farmers clear a piece of land by slashing or cutting down trees and bushes. Okay, they cut down the trees, they burn it, which releases the nutrients into the soil. Now the crops are grown in this cleared field for few years. Okay, so the nutrients which through the burning of trees, there they grow their crops. Okay, so after repeatedly using the patch of land, the soil loses its nutrients. Okay, obviously, so it is abandoned, so they are leaving it just like that. Then they clear another plot and then do the same thing. Okay, so meanwhile young trees grow in the old field. In this way, soil fertility is restored. So it's a natural process. That is why some arguments or debates when it happened, like whether slash and burn is like wrong for the system, ecological system. It is not actually wrong because naturally it is getting replenished also. It's not like humans are cutting trees and then constructing houses or buildings. That is actually a wrong way. But here slash and burn, which tribes people used to do, that is actually a good way because it will be automatically replenished also. They'll leave that and then go to another plot, and then later again they'll come back when the nutrients are restored. So that is a very good way of cultivation. Okay. The staple food, okay, these kind of things may be useful. Staple food is manioc, also known as cassava, that grows under the ground like the potato, okay, like it's growing under the ground. They also eat queen ants and egg sacs, cash crops like coffee, maize, cocoa. Any essay kind of thing or any answer related to a general thing about the people about Amazon, then only these are useful, else I don't think prelims and all these questions will come, okay. Maloca, steeply slanting roof, it's their house type, okay, apartment like houses called Maloca. Life of the people slowly changing, heart of the forest could be reached only by navigating the river. 1970s, the Trans Amazon Highway made all parts of the rainforest accessible. So initially transport issues were there, now everything is interconnected. Indigenous population, I'll tell only important points, okay, rest we'll just scroll down. The development activities are leading to the gradual destruction of the biologically diverse rainforest. So obviously wherever human intervention is there, there will be diversion of land and then destruction will be happening. So you can see the images also how the forest is depleting. That is why government is also doing lot of schemes to protect the environment. The CAMPA is in news, okay. CAMPA, please go and read the current affairs. Compensating the compensation afforestation for trees. Wherever trees are getting cut, equal number of trees should be grown also somewhere else. So that CAMPA provisions, new rules have come. Please go and read it. It is a possible question for 2018 mains. So that was about Amazon. Similarly, India, we'll see Ganga Brahmaputra basin, which is the huge river basin, you know. Brahmaputra is also in news because of the Siang river pollution. You can tell Siang is actually another name for Brahmaputra. Brahmaputra has a lot of names, okay. Brahmaputra, when it originates in Tibet, it is called Yarlung Zangpo. Then it enters Arunachal Pradesh in India. That time it is called Siang. Then it, when it comes into Assam only, it is called Brahmaputra, okay. We have this Namami Brahmaputra video also on YouTube now, viral. Please go and watch that video. So Brahmaputra river, Assam gives it name. And then after that again, it will be called Jamuna or something when it enters Bangladesh. Later it will join with Ganga, which will be called Padma at that time. And then finally it will be merged into Meghna river, and then it will go to the Bay of Bengal. Okay, so it has a variety of different names. So you should know that flow and path. Okay, river system, definitely one question will come in UPSC prelims. Last year it was Teesta river, this time it can be Brahmaputra, it can be the Mandovi river in Goa, because these are in news, or Kaveri river, that is in news. So whichever in news, UPSC will definitely put a question, you should know. We'll do a river system topic someday, but now let's focus on Ganga Brahmaputra basin. So I think I'll show you the picture that is more useful. This is the Ganga Brahmaputra basin. So if you see, Ganga river is here, okay. So you should know tributaries are here, left bank and right bank tributaries. I think Ram Ganga and Gomti will be the first two, which is originating in India itself. And then after that, Ghagra, Gandak, Kosi will be there, which are originating outside India, but they are left bank tributaries. Okay, this left and right, you should know how they are deciding that. From the origin, you should see the left, okay. Because Ganga is originating from here, Gangotri, Uttarakhand. That time, from there, you should see the left. That is the left and right. That's how you decide left tributary and right tributary, okay. These are basic things. Yamuna is also one right bank tributary of Ganga. Yamuna is there, Son is there. Then for Yamuna itself, there are 4-5 tributaries like Ken, Betwa, Chambal and all. Ken Betwa is in use because of the river linking project. Panna Tiger Reserve is getting submerged in Madhya Pradesh. I'm telling you all current affairs so that you get used to these things, okay? So try to know current affairs related to these kind of things more than the basin system, okay? Maybe geography optional students may have to focus more on the static part of here. Otherwise, current affairs is more important. Oxbow Lake, we have seen like rivers will form meanders, and sometimes one portion, a sea portion, will get cut off from the main river, and that small sea section is called the Oxbow Lake. Okay. River Brahmaputra is known by different names, like I told. Try to find out the names again. I have already told it, but still. Population density, it means the number of persons that live in 1 square kilometer of area. So that is the population density. Okay. So just giving examples, these are all old statistics, not important. Again, map we have seen. Environment plays a dominant role in the distribution of population. We have seen river systems. Wherever river systems and fertile land is there, more population will be there. Cultivation of crops. Okay, crop names are there. Wheat, maize, sorghum, gram, millets are the other crops that are grown. Okay. Agriculture is the main occupation. These are basic things you will be knowing, Ganga Brahmaputra lifestyle. So again, pictures are there, paddy cultivation, tea garden in Assam. Mangrove forest is there in the Sundarban Delta, you can tell, near West Bengal. Terraces are built on steep slopes to create flat surfaces on which crops are grown. You know this terrace farming. If you go to Kerala or you go to the northeast, you will see this in plenty. Okay, it's a very beautiful site to watch also, so try visiting those places. Coniferous trees like pine, deodar, fir can be seen in Arunachal Pradesh. Okay, in this Uttarakhand, Sikkim, Arunachal Pradesh, which are Himalayan states also. So there you can see these kind of coniferous trees because the climate is cool and the slopes are steep. Okay, variety of wildlife in the basin, elephants, tigers, deer. So these are all common animals found. Rhinoceros, you know, they are getting protected in the Manas and Kaziranga in Assam. Aquatic life. One of the state has recently declared the Ganga dolphin as their state animal also. Something in the northeast, try to find out that state. Fish and rice, the staple food, you know, West Bengal, northeast and all, fish is like more common. So pictures you please go through as I'm scrolling. It will just help you. The blind dolphin, which I told, it's also called Susu. Ganga Brahmaputra. Chemicals killing these species. So this is in news. Questions have already come, maybe not getting repeated, but you should know. Okay, again, some stories are given, which is not required for us. Pictures of the Varanasi Ghat, which is more popular in India now, even after Swachh Bharat Mission and all, the place is getting much more cleaner. So it's in news. So most of the Uttar Pradesh states, Uttarakhand states, and the small cities in there, it's mentioned here. Not required for us in detail now. Kolkata is an important port on the Hooghly River. So port system, 12 major ports are there in India. Now the 13th port is getting constructed. So you should know where is the 13th port. Tourism is another important activity on this basin. Okay, you know the Hriday scheme, Prasad scheme, lot of schemes are being promoted by Indian government to promote tourism in most of the river basins, more of the cultural part of India. Okay, Taj Mahal is on the bank of river Yamuna. Allahabad in the confluence of river Ganga, Yamuna, and one imaginary river is also there, Triveni Sangam, Deltel, Saraswati River, I think, which is not existing now. And again, tourism related places. So this chapter deals with basically the Ganga River basin, the Brahmaputra River basin. You have seen a lot of pictures, just getting familiarized. Okay, detail we'll anyway study. Tributaries of all these things, distributaries of all these things, I'll teach you myself. Okay, I'll take different videos for that. Amazon basin was there. Now just five questions will be there obviously at the end of this chapter. Toucans, we saw it was a bird, we saw the picture also in Amazon. Manioc was a staple food of Amazon, this also we saw in the lecture. Kolkata is located on the river Hooghly. Deodars and firs, we saw coniferous trees in the Himalayan states. Bengal tiger is found in the delta area, you can tell, Sundarban Delta. Okay, so that is chapter 8. Let's go to chapter 9, which will be some other location. I think it will be the temperate grasslands. Yes, temperate grasslands. So in last chapter itself we have seen the savanna was a tropical grassland in Africa, but weld was a temperate grassland of Africa, and down was in Australia, prairies in North America, and I think in South America also we had something, pampas or something. So we'll see the names in detail and a little bit of more features. Okay, this is just an explanation of what we saw in the previous chapter. World's grasslands, two broad categories, temperate and tropical. Okay, so prairies, temperate grassland, North America. Okay, this picture. Okay, green grass, short grass, nutritious grass. So seeing the picture itself, you'll understand most of the things. So Latin name it is, which means meadow. Okay, grazing land for animals, for cows and all. So prairies are treeless, but near the low-lying plains, flanking river valleys, woodlands would be found. Tall grass, okay, tall grass, treeless, so these kind of things. Actually a sea of grass. So any kind of this description, if UPSC frames in any massive following or statements, try to relate it. Okay, prairies in North America, temperate grasslands, treeless, but it has tall grass, 2 meters high, and sea of grass. Okay, the prairies are bound by the Rocky Mountains in the west, Great Lakes in the east. Okay, there are five lakes in USA. Try to find out the name. Okay, there will be Lake Superior, Lake Michigan, and I forgot the five names, but the five important lakes which they call the Great Lakes in USA. Okay. Then Mississippi River is one important river in the USA. This is some other river name which is given for Canada. So we are just familiarizing with the geography of that region. Okay, see map is there, so which is much more easy for us to understand. So Rocky Mountains you can see here in the west, Prairies is here, United States, Canada, both the places. Mississippi River will be somewhere here, Great Lakes will be somewhere here in the border of Canada and USA. And you should know it is all in the northern hemisphere. Okay, above Tropic of Cancer. Tropic of Cancer is here, passing through Mexico. Okay. The country names of Tropic of Cancer and all, I'll make some trick and make another video how to remember the country names. Okay, Red Indians, the traditional people there. The prairies were home of other tribes also, like the Apache, Crow, Cree and Pawnee. So these tribe names also UPSC sometimes makes difficult questions for students. So you should know these are all tribes which are there in the prairies. Okay, Apache, Red Indians, Crow, Cree, Pawnee. Okay, climate, Chinook, one hot wind. UPSC has asked a question already, because Lu, we have seen Lu is a hot dry wind which blows in the daytime. This is again a hot wind that blows in the winter. Okay, so try to know the difference. Lu is in the daytime, usually hot and dry. This is especially in the winter. Okay, Chinook, hot wind again. The UPSC will just tweak this very slightly. They'll make it cold wind or they'll make it summer. Okay, they'll just confuse you, because you will only, if you have read this, you will know the answer. That is why we should read NCERTs. Okay, and therefore raises the temperature within a short time. This increase in temperature results in the melting of snow, making pasture land available for grazing of animals. So this is about Chinook. Climate, heart of the continent. Climate is continental type with extreme temperatures. So again, temperature they have given 20 degree. Winter it will be minus 20 degree in Canada. Chinook wind we saw already, which is a hot wind which blows in winter. Flora and fauna, you can see the cowboys with the horse. America, in old American movies, Hollywood movies, you would have seen this. Practically treeless, we have seen. Water is available, trees such as willows, alders and poplars. Okay, certain areas where water is there, certain trees are also there. So definite statement, if UPSC asks like it is totally treeless, it is false. Okay, rainfall of 50 cm, suitable for farming, soil is fertile. Major crops are maize, okay, not rice, maize, potatoes, soybean, cotton. Alfalfa, this was asked in UPSC. Alfalfa is a grass seen in which area? It is in the prairies. Okay, areas where rainfall is very little are unreliable. Grasses are short and sparse. Large cattle, obviously when grass is there, cattle will be there. Okay, ranches is a term used. Large cattle farms called ranches. Picture of a bison. Okay, cowboys. So cowboys you should relate with that cattle farms, which is ranches. Okay, bison is American buffalo. Picture is there. Then other animals, rabbits, coyotes, gophers, prairie dog. Combine is actually this particular machine you see, a single machine which can combine the task of sowing, plowing and threshing. That is a 3-in-1 machine. So you should know India and USA, what is the difference in agriculture. India is a agrarian society, you can tell, where subsistence agriculture is done, where for feeding their own population they are dependent on agriculture. But USA and all, it is more of commercial agriculture. Okay, they do it everything through plantation, through machinery, and they focus more on exports more than doing something for themselves. So that is the difference between USA and India. So this combined kind of machines is very popular there, especially where these kind of grasses are available. Important cities they have given, not much important city names which are there along the prairies. People, very hardworking, successfully harness technology to utilize their natural resources. So that is the difference. The other countries are so much developed because they invest a lot in their human resource, okay, and they are very hardworking. They will be profit motive countries, because capitalist economy, not like India where it's a mixed economy. So they are more focused on making profit. They will be ready to do any kind of work and any technology improvement to make profit. That is why they are far more developed and India is far more behind now, okay. But India has the capacity and India is moving in the right direction. Hopefully we will also be in the top 3 economies by next 10 or 15 years. Okay, so then surplus food producer, like I told, prairies are also called granaries of the world. They create, use it and also export it. Okay, surplus of wheat production. Dairy farming is another major industry. Great Lakes, Atlantic Coast, dairy farming, etc. So they are all using technology to improve it. Mineral deposits are there in huge numbers. So the road, railway, canals, all these things are developed. Industrial region in the world. You know, USA has been independent very long back, 1774, not like India in 1947. So they have been working on their economy and using all their resources efficiently. That is why they are that much developed. So that is about the prairies. Now the belt we will see, which is in Africa, African temperate grassland. Okay, tropical grassland is savanna, which is a different thing. In Jungle Book movies, you will see tall grasses and all. That is savanna. This is temperate grasslands where short grasses will be there. Again, Dutch settlers gave the name. Not much important. So, just telling their borders, Drakensberg Mountains is there, Kalahari Desert is there on either side. Then, northeastern part, high veld, not much important. See the image. Okay, here, this is veld. Okay, in Africa. Africa, you should know all the three lines, equator, Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn, all three passes through Africa. Okay, climate. Influence of Indian Ocean is there, left side you know the Atlantic Ocean is there. Winters are cold and dry. Temperatures between 5 and 10 in July is the coldest month. So this much only, they don't have negative temperatures and all, okay? 5 and 10 degree. Summers are short and warm. Johannesburg, capital of South Africa, that is according 20 degree Celsius in summer. Wells receive rainfall mainly in the summer months from November to February. This is mainly because of the warm ocean currents, okay? Warm ocean currents. Ocean currents is very important for us. So because of that, summer has that type of climate. Receive rainfall mainly in the summer month. Then flora and fauna, you can see the picture of a leopard here. Red grass grows in bush wells, okay. This kind of features you should know. Acacia trees, actually acacia and marula seem to be grown. Lions, African lion, leopards, cheetah. People, cattle rearing and mining. Mining is very important. Africa is actually having a lot of gold mines and diamond mines. You can see one picture here. I think it's a Kimberley. Yeah, Kimberley process is in news actually. Kimberley certification. I think India has become the vice chairman of the group which decides the Kimberley certifications or something. So that was there in news 1 week ago. Please read about Kimberley certification process. Just Google it, you will get it. Kimberley certification. Okay. India is there somewhere in picture, so it is important. Then. Main crops, maize, wheat, barley, oats and potato. Cash crops like tobacco, sugarcane and cotton are grown. Sheep rearing is very important. Merino sheep is a popular species. Okay, these kind of things also you can pick up. Okay, because NCERT mentions it, merino sheep in Africa. Dairy farming is the next important occupation. Cattle is rare. So temperate grasslands, generally if you see, it is more of crops, good crops are grown and animal rearing is there. This is the general characteristics of anything which you take. Again, gold and diamond, I told, mining. Gold capital of the world, Johannesburg. Static information for any other non-UPSC exam, Johannesburg. Kimberley famous for diamond mines. It was a British colony. Mineral rich area has a well-developed network of transport. So that is all about chapter 9. Simply questions we will see. River Mississippi, USA. Drakensberg Mountain, weld. Merino species. Merino is a sheep. We have seen it. Okay, now just know. Kimberley is famous for diamonds. So that is all about chapter 9. Let's finish off chapter 10 also quickly. It might be desert region because all the other regions we have seen. Life in the deserts. So I think India, Thar Desert, India, Rajasthan also it will be discussed in detail. Desert, it is an arid region characterized by extremely high or low temperatures and scarce vegetation. Okay, then important points. Low rainfall, scanty vegetation, extreme temperature. These are the features. There can be hot deserts or cold deserts. Okay, there are cold deserts in our Himachal Pradesh, that is there. There is a biosphere reserve itself in Himachal Pradesh. Out of the total 18 biosphere reserves, you have to know all the names. Okay, 18 names. 10 are recognized by UNESCO. Under the Man and Biosphere Program, MAB. So other than the 10th one, latest one was Agastyamala in Kerala, but 18 of them are there. Other 8 are there in India. The 18 names you should know. If you want, I will make a table for that and show you. It might be there in a Facebook page, but YouTube also I'll try to put it. So these are, I'm telling related things every now and then while we are doing chapters. So please try to focus on whatever I tell. Okay. More than the text which is being shown, whatever I say is becoming more and more important in the lectures in geography, okay? Because I am telling everything which is there in news. And MCQs, if you need just to learn it, it's all available in our Facebook page. Please contact to buy them. The hot desert, So again, different location. Sahara Desert is the one that they are taking as first example. You can tell. Hot desert, world's largest desert. Touches 11 countries. So you can imagine how much big it is. Algeria, Chad, Egypt, Libya, Mali, Mauritania, Morocco, Niger, Sudan. These countries, most of them are also the same countries which are through which the Tropic of Cancer passes. Okay, so if you can learn it together, that's also fine. The countries which pass through Tropic of Cancer and the countries which surrounds the Western Sahara or the total Sahara. Okay, so that is almost same. I'll maybe show you the map is there. So here if you see, this is the Sahara Desert, the north or the west, north and west both, it's totally Saharan desert. So Tropic of Cancer also, if you see, it's passing through here. So Western Sahara, Mauritania, Mali, Niger, Chad, Sudan is not there, I think. Tropic of Cancer, I'm telling you, okay. And Egypt is there, Libya, Algeria, and it will pass through Saudi Arabia, UAE, and all, and then reach India also. India also, Tropic of Cancer is almost passing through the center, okay. 8 states in India touches the Tropic of Cancer. You should know. There is a trick for it. I'll teach you all these things in a separate video. But you should learn these things as and when I'm telling. In blue box, something is given. Sahara once used to be a lush green plain. Okay, earlier it was not a desert. Cave paintings in Sahara Desert show that there used to be rivers with crocodiles, elephants, lions, giraffes. So that much greenery was there at once. That is what is historical evidence shows us. Okay, there are caves and cave painting shows us that it was a green place once upon a time. Okay, Al Azizia in Sahara Desert, south of Tripoli, Libya, recorded the highest temperature of 57 degree in 1922. So this is the highest temperature ever recorded. Libya, I think Tripoli is the capital of Libya. So Al Azizia is the name of the place where the highest temperature was ever recorded in history. That was very long back, about 100 years back. Okay. So climate, you know, scorching hot and parts dry, short rainy season. Sky is cloudless and clear. Okay, you should know that. Cloudless and clear. Because there is no much evaporation or something, or there is no water. Water is less. But whatever is there, it will be faster. Even though it is less, the temperature is high, so the evaporation will be faster. Days are unbelievably hot. The temperature during the day may soar as high as 50 degrees Celsius. Okay, imagine now with the 35 or 40 degree itself in some cities in India, people are telling like it is the, not even 35, when it reaches 30 itself, people are telling it's unbearable. Okay, people are used to the 16 degree, 17 degree AC climate. So that much unbelievable high temperature is there in African deserts. The nights may be freezing cold with temperature nearing 0 degrees. So you should know it's an extreme. Daytime it is unbelievably hot and night it is even reaching 0 degree. So you should know the extremity of climate in Sahara Desert. Flora and fauna, you will be knowing obviously. Date palms, camels, hyenas, jackals, foxes, scorpions, different types of rats and rodents will be also there in desert. Cactus, acacia, which can store water. That is why it's found in dry regions. Snakes and lizards. Picture oasis, you can see small water body. Scientists have actually found skeletons of fish in the desert. So they're telling the skeletons of fish were there, okay, but now it is, there is no huge water bodies, and also scientists are still thinking or researching on how, what was the past of Sahara Desert. People, again, tribe names, Bedouins and Tuaregs. Okay, I think long back about some pygmy tribe, something UPSC have asked a question where they are found. So this becomes a little bit important. Try to make notes or a table so that it will be easy for you to revise later. Nomadic tribes, goats, sheep, camel, horses. Animals provide them with milk, hides from which they leather, for belts, slippers, water, bottle, okay. They're all again same way of sustenance, what they do. Animal rearing is there, and cultivation might be little less because of the climatic problems. Okay. Nile River, which is also called the gift of Egypt, is called the gift of Nile, and it is what to say, the lifeline, you can tell, of majority of countries. Okay, Nile is actually not one single river, it is actually White Nile and Blue Nile. Two rivers are combining together and forming the bigger one. Okay, you should know where it is originating, the Blue Nile and the White Nile and all. The Victoria Lake will be there. These are all related things in geography. When we learn mapping, we'll see. Okay. Crops such as rice, wheat, barley or beans are also there. There is cultivation, but it is less. But cultivation is more towards the Nile River, not in the western side of Africa. Okay. Egyptian cotton, famous worldwide. Discovery of oil. So oil is there. You know the OPEC countries, the oil petroleum exporting countries, OPEC, many African countries are part of it. Okay. The trick to remember, the OPEC countries are already there in our CTS series. Please go and watch that video. 13 countries are there as of now, 12 countries and 13th, I think, Gabon in Africa is the 13th one to join. Indonesia was recently suspended from the OPEC countries. So these kind of current affairs try to know about countries, okay? Algeria, Libya, Egypt, these are all countries which are oil producing also. So it helps in their economy. Gleaming glass cased office building towers, just explaining how the city looks like and all, not required. Depressions are formed when the wind blows away the sands, okay? In the depressions where underground water reaches the surface, oasis is formed. So telling about again oasis, water body, small water body available in deserts. Date palms. Morocco is, okay, one largest oasis they're telling in Morocco, okay. Morocco is somewhere in the North Africa, okay, near Strait of Gibraltar, you can tell. So these are some basic things about it. Cold desert, Ladakh. La means mountain, you know, a lot of mountain passes you will be learning where it is ending with La. So La basically means mountain pass. Dark means country, so that is how Ladakh name has come. Dras, one of the coldest inhabited place on earth. Okay, Dras is actually the second most coldest place after Siberia in the whole world, I am telling. Okay, that much cold it is. Not throughout the year, but there are cases of going extreme temperature. That is Dras, Siachen Glacier, those places you should know. Our army men are still serving in those kind of harsh climates. Okay, Ladakh is a cold desert living in the, sorry, cold desert lying in the Great Himalayas on the eastern side of Jammu and Kashmir. The Karakoram Range in the north and the Zanskar Mountain in the south. Okay, UPSC once asked to order this also, like in order. Karakoram will come, then I think Ladakh will come, then Zanskar will come, then Pir Panjal will come, Dauladhar Range will come. So that kind of arranging in order from north to south also, you have to be importantly preparing, okay, when you learn these mountain ranges. Especially inside India, don't worry about what is there in North America or something, but India, mountain ranges in Himalaya, you should know the order in north to south. Rivers, deep valley and gorges, several glaciers are found in Ladakh, for example, the Gangri Glacier, okay, maybe they are, okay, Gangri Glacier, Gangotri Yamunotri Glacier is different, that also will be there, but not in Jammu and Kashmir, it will be in Uttarakhand. Again, you can see the picture, which will be much more interesting or easy to understand, you can tell. Here, Kargil is here. Leh is here, Zaskar River, Indus River, Shyok River, Siachen Glacier is here, okay, this is with India, but these places, Gilgit-Baltistan is with Pakistan now, Pakistan occupied, and similarly here, Aksai Chin is there, which is with China. So there are problems in Kashmir, we know that. Baralacha La, so it's a mountain pass, so you should know these kind of names, okay. I'm not going into detail now, just showing you, Jozila Pass. Temperature minus 30 degree, minus 40 degree. Ladakh is also known as Khapa Chan, which means snow land. Okay. Chiru or the Tibetan antelope is an endangered species. Okay, you should know that endangered species, Tibetan antelope, which is also called Chiru. It is hunted for the wool known as Shartush, which is light in weight and extremely warm. So for warm clothes and all, they use the wool from Chiru. Sheeps will be obviously there, but other than that, Chiru, which is Tibetan antelope, is also there. Okay. Very little rainfall, only 10 cm every year, freezing wind, burning hot sunlight. Visit Ladakh whenever you can, it's a very beautiful place. Obviously, tourism is spoiling it, but still, it is very good compared to any other place in India. Flora and fauna, scanty patches of grasses and shrubs for animals to graze. So all it has only that much thing, okay, and willows and poplars are seen in the valleys, okay. There are some trees with which even the cricket bats are made, okay. The cricket bats are made from certain bark, willow trees and all. During the summers, fruit trees such as apples and all, you'll get in plenty, okay. You buy 1 kilo apple from here and 1 kilo apple from there, you will understand the price difference itself. That much you will get for very cheap rates. So that is the main plantations there. Robins, red starts, Tibetan snowcock, these are all birds, okay, common birds. Animals are wild goats, sheep, yak, special kind of dogs. Milk, meat, hides, again same thing. Yak is there, yak's milk. Even in Jammu and Kashmir or in Himachal Pradesh and all, these are common, okay. See, I told you, finest cricket bats are made from the wood of the willow trees. People, Muslims, Buddhist, okay, in majority. Some famous monasteries. not everything is important, but like Tawang and all is important. Tawang is not in this side. Tawang, I'm just telling, it is in Arunachal Pradesh, the place of Dalai Lama, you can tell. So that is in debate all the time. Like the Doklam issue was there recently. Tawang is also important. Thiksay Monastery. Lot of monasteries are there. If you visit Leh Ladakh, you will understand. Most of the important tourist sites are monasteries only. Okay, it's very beautiful. It's very peaceful to be there. They have their own rituals, their own culture. The National Highway 1A connect Leh in Kashmir Valley through the Zojila Pass. So important national highways which are in use also sometimes are in sometimes are very important for UPSC. Like I think National Highway 10 was in use sometime back because it connects the Sikkim region with the northeast. Okay, the Siliguri corridor, you can tell there. Because of the Doklam issue itself, that small highway, it was in use. Okay, National Highway 10. So try to remember important highways which are in use. Don't sit and by heart all the national highways. Okay, but important ones which are in use, you have to know. Manali Leh Highway, it is the best highway. If you are a traveler, you can tell Manali Leh, you should travel one day. Most beautiful ride it is. You should not go in some other closed vehicle or something. You should have a bike ride or something, and you should see Manali Leh Highway. It's most, it's one of the most beautiful places. Rotangla, Barala Chala, Lungala Chala, you should, everything, maybe north to south or something, you can do it in one shot. You take the map of mountain passes and then list it down, read north to south, and then that's over. Okay, read all the mountain passes together, don't do one by one. Now because NCRT covers only like this, we are just seeing it, but any other day we'll cover all the mountain passes from west to east of India. Everything we'll see. Even the southern India, we have the mountain passes or the gaps in the western guts. Okay, like the Palghat, Talghat, Borghat, there are many things. So you should know which is in Maharashtra, which is in Kerala. That order you should know. Okay, tourism, major activity like I told. From across the world, people are visiting there. Life of people is undergoing change due to modernization. The people of Ladakh have centuries learned to, so they have their century old tradition and all, and they are just slowly revive, changing to because of modernization. Okay, just their policy, nothing is discarded or wasted. So that is all about all the three regions we saw. Questions are here. Sahara is located in which part of Africa? Northern side. Sahara is what type of desert? Hot desert. Ladakh desert is mainly inhabited by Buddhist and Muslims. Option B. Okay, deserts are characterized by scanty vegetation. Okay, not heavy precipitation, not low evaporation. Option A. Okay, Hemis in Ladakh is a monastery. Egypt is famous for growing, I think, Egypt cotton, it is the answer. So this is how NCRT class 7th has gone and it is ended. Now we begin class 8. Let me see what all chapters are there and I'll make a video for that. Okay, till then, thank you. Give your feedback. Have a nice day.